Alright, today I'm going to be sharpening up one of my Santokus. This is just a cheapy KitchenAid one, but I use it quite a bit. And haven't sharpened it for a bit, and it's getting pretty dull. So. Cuts, but pretty rough. What I'm going to start off on is the Chapton Pro. This is 320 grit. Add a little soapy water. All this is I don't know, 5 or 6 drops of Dawn dish soap and some water. Very, very fine burr worked up. I'm going to switch to the other side. bit more work than I thought it would. That's all right. Alright, got it where I want it to with it. 320 grit, and I'm going to switch over to a shaft in 1K, 1000 grit. Got a burr worked up on both sides. Now I'm going to do some refining passes, kind of try and knock that burr down a little bit, minimize it before I move on. I'm going to take passes, but I'm not going to use any downward force, just the weight of my hand with the knife. Kind of periodically checking for seeing how big the burr is, if it's getting any smaller. I don't want to use too much force and flip it to the other side. Let's create another one on the other side. All All right, got most of the burr removed. What I'm gonna do is clean the surface of the stone really well. Try and get any contaminants off. I'm gonna take some end of the edge leading passes, the same angle. Try and refine the edge a little bit more, clean it up. It feels pretty good. Grab a piece of paper here and see what's at. Feel a couple little hang-ups, but that's to be expected. I didn't really take a lot of refining passes on it, but what I'm going to use now is a ceramic rod. This is an Idahoan rod, and I think it's rated between 12 and 1600 grit. One thing you want to keep or be aware of when you're using is, you know, this is a ceramic rod. And it's really not any different than a ceramic stone. The grit on this is pretty close to the fine of the, you know, that Spyderco 302F, the fine bench stone. But one big difference is on the bench stone, you've got, you know, 2, 2.5, 3 inches, depending on what kind of stone you're using, of surface area. When you go to something like a ceramic rod, you've got a much, much finer point of contact. So you want to be really aware of your pressure that you're using, and not use too much. I sharpen probably around 15 degrees. What I'm going to do is put a little bit of a micro bevel on this, probably 18, 20 degrees, just to add a little durability. When I do any kind of heavy cutting with it, it kind of tends to roll the edge a little bit, so I try and stop that from happening in the future, hopefully. You know, you've probably, you know, seen this on YouTube. I know, you know, a lot of culinary schools teach this, and how to find your angle on a stone or a ceramic rod. This, of course, flat, vertical is 90, cut that in half, 45, cut it in half. Again, 22 and a half, and then reduce it a little bit, pretty close to 20 degrees. You know, if you get one of these and you're not really comfortable doing it like that, you know, Amazon and eBay, they sell little guides that slide on. They're held on by rubber bands, and it's just predetermined angles. You know, I've seen them probably $8-$10, and they work well, and they help you develop muscle memory. But after you do it a bit, you won't need them. And again, you want to use very, very light pressure when using these. These ceramics are very, very hard, and, you know, they cut very slow, but they work really well for the final apexing. So, it does a good job at removing any burr on there. And you know, it's putting a really nice edge on there. So. Once they get dirty, you just take a regular old eraser and scrub them clean. Super simple. I think I bought this one off Amazon for just under 40 bucks, and I would highly recommend getting this over a cheaper one. They last a long, long time, and it's a little bit more, but well worth it. A little bit more work. Now I'm going to finish up on the strop that I just cleaned up. Aluminum oxide, the old white bar compound. Now I'm stropping. I'm using just the weight of my hand with the knife. I'm not putting any downward pressure. You just don't need it. Set it on there. Basically, you want to raise the spine of that knife until that little shadow, that little gap in between the edge and the leather disappears, and it's pretty close. It doesn't have to be perfect. What you don't want to do is really press down. You don't want to use a lot of angle, because it'll quickly, I don't want to say ruin your edge, but that's basically what it'll do. Notice it get duller fairly quick if you do this. All that good. Seems to be nice and sharp now. Again, if you've never had a ceramic rod, do yourself a favor and get one. They work really well. I recommend the Idahoan. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, comments, please feel free to leave them below.